Hello, I'm Charlotte Briggs from Bay Path University in Longmeadow, Massachusetts, in the United States. And my co-author is Allison Doubleday at the College of Dentistry in the University of Illinois at Chicago, also in the United States. Thank you for your interest in our article, Group Learning Assessments as a Vital Consideration in the Implementation of New Peer Learning Pedagogies in the Basic Science Curriculum of Health Profession Programs. The goal of our paper is to provide an overview and a commentary on the literature concerning approaches to assessment in health profession curricula that use peer learning as a significant component of instruction. We especially wish to address the needs of basic science faculty who are implementing peer learning pedagogies for the first time, since group learning has a longer tradition in clinical aspects of health profession education, but is relatively new in basic science aspects. Many educators who implement peer learning pedagogies, especially those who are new to using small groups in the learning process, wonder whether it is better to assess students based on their individual performance or to assess groups of students together, or under what circumstances individual or group grades might be more appropriate, and what options might be available for combining group and individual assessment in the grading process. This paper very briefly reviews common goals for peer learning and then some of the underlying principles of peer pedagogies that provide the context for thinking about principles of assessment in peer learning. We then provide a brief overview of approaches to grading in group contexts, in which we discuss those contexts for assessment, who conducts the assessment, what is assessed, and how group and individual performance can contribute to a grade. After discussing assessments in peer learning in general, we turn to the topic of peer pedagogies and their assessment in health professions education, with particular attention to team-based learning and problem-based learning pedagogies, which are gaining prominence in a number of countries. In this section of the paper, we discuss the individual and group readiness assurance tests that are essential to TBL, and the triple jump and the objective structured clinical examination, or OSCE, that have developed within the PBL tradition in health professions programs. Finally, we provide our own views concerning the importance of using assessments in peer learning to support rather than undermine collaboration in small groups. And we discuss the potential for health professions educators to get more out of peer learning assessments by using them as a vehicle to improve professional collaboration and communication skills. Toward this latter goal, we cite weaknesses in current approaches to teaching and assessing peer collaboration, which are often based on personal experience and preferences, and we call for training and assessments to be informed by the latest scholarship on improving effectiveness and reducing biases in group communications and in decision-making processes of groups, all of which are essential to improving continuity of patient care and reducing the frequency of medical errors. Our paper provides a conceptual introduction to the topic of assessment in peer learning and is therefore not a how-to manual. But with this introduction and our list of references, we hope to provide you with an orientation that will help you think about assessment of group learning in a more informed way and to find the resources you need to delve deeper into any particular aspect of the topic that interests you. Thank you.